Well, the Prague Masters has come to an end, but there is no dearth of chess action, especially for Indians, because the Aeroflot Open has begun, and the A group of Aeroflot Open has only players about 25-50. That's written in the regulations. However, the tournament is very kind in a way to Indian players. It has opened up its doors for many of the youngsters who are below the rating threshold so that they get the required exposure. And as a result, we see a lot of youngsters, young Indian players fighting it out against the top GMs in the world. And in this video, I'm going to show you two games, one by Bharath Subramaniyam, 12-year-old boy, and another one by M. Pranesh, 13-year-old. And both of them beat very well-established GMs in the world of chess. I'll speak more about it. But what I want to say through this video is, first of all, to give you a glimpse of their talent, but also to show you how these youngsters don't really fear these world-class GMs. They just play their game and outplay them without any chance given. So let's have a look first at Pranesh. Pranesh's game. He is born in 2006. He recently made his first GM nom at the Delhi Open. And he's playing at the Aeroflot Open. And he faced Boris Savchenko, who's rated 2573. Pranesh's rating is 2425. And Pranesh opened with 1e4. Now, after d5, which was Savchenko's move, Pranesh took knight f6, knight f3. Now, usually black takes with his knight. But here, Savchenko took with his queen, which is not very common. Knight c3, gaining a tempo, queen d6, d4, c6, g3. Now, we are in one of the main lines of the queen d6 line in the Scandinavian. Bg4, bishop g2, but once again Savchenko surprised us with the move queen d8. Knight d7 would have been pretty normal, or even say e6, but queen d8, h3, bishop f5, and here maybe bishop h5 is possible, but also, you can just take and stay solid. You know, this position, although would be slightly better for white, is not so bad. Bishop f5, g4, bishop e6, and now bishop f4, h5. So, black is playing very weirdly in this game. You know, first of all, he put his bishop here, blocking this guy on f8. Then instead of developing, he's now trying to break the structure. So very ambitious play, but at the same time, I don't think it meets the demands of the position. Pranesh very confidently castles. It's true that his king side is slightly weakened, you know, by these pawn advances, but he realizes that he has such a lead in development that now he's already threatening moves like knight e5. So queen f5 was played, and now queen d2 defending the bishop, connecting the rooks. Now h4. This is really uncompromising play by Savchenko, but it doesn't work. Rook fe1, knight d7. And here I would like you to take some time and try to figure out what would you play here as white. So it's time to start doing something concrete in this position. And that's the reason why Pranesh found the move d5. This is a tremendous move. It can be taken in three ways, but all of them are inadequate. First of all, cd5 is met with knight d4, attacking both the pieces. And after queen g6, I go knight b5, threatening a check. And this is what happened in the game. So we'll come to it. If you take with the bishop, then I can play knight d4, once again attacking the queen. The queen doesn't really have a good square to go to, say queen g6. I take, take, and knight b5. And once again, this is just a very strong attack for White, not only is he threatening knight c7, but also knight d6 check. And this is big trouble. So you take, let's say with the queen, once again knight d4. This time the attack comes from the bishop on g2. And next I can pick this up. So for example, queen c7, I can even play queen c4, I can play b3, pushing the queen back. Later, I could take with the rook or even with the knight, and it's huge attack. So cd5 was played, knight d4, queen g6, knight b5, threatening a check, and after rook c8, came queen a5, b6, queen into a7, queen f5, and queen b7. And this is where Savchenko resigned the game, because knight c7 is coming up, and if you move the rook from here, let's say you take on c2, I just give a check, and it's a mate, sort of a mate on the back rank. So black resigned the game, and it was just 21 moves, and Pranesh won. After this game ended, Jakob Agard, who's a well-known trainer, commented on Facebook saying he met Pranesh when he was in India, played a blitz game with him, and lost 1.5 half, where the youngster simply outplayed him. And it was all the more impressive because Jakob would get winning positions out of the opening, and then Pranesh would outplay him. So that's how strong this youngster is. He doesn't really believe too much in opening preparation. He's a very natural player, and that's seen in his games. Maybe he's also worked now on his openings, and that's showing good results. He is training with Ramesh. Doesn't come as a surprise, because a lot of young talents are coming up from Chennai and Chess Gurukul. And the game which I'm going to show you next is also from a boy who is from Chess Gurukul. This is Bharath Subramaniyam. Now Bharath was playing Gabriel Sargissian, and Gabriel Sargissian is much stronger than Boris Savchenko. Sargissian is rated 2689, so very close to 2700, and one of the top seeds in the event. Bharath is 2402. He's the second last seed in the event, and he's right now 2.5 out of 3. He was playing with the black pieces, and the game reached the semi-slav. Now Bharath was a part of the Kramnik Gelfand Microsense program. And I was there for 10 days. I saw him closely, and I feel the boy is tremendously talented when it comes to tactical vision. He is really good when it comes to calculation. He's very accurate. And in this position, in this game, he gives no chance to his opponent. So first of all, g3 is not the main move. The main moves are e3 or bishop g5. g3, he just took on c4. Bishop g2, he saved the pawn. Now after knight e5, he played a6. So the point is that if you play bishop b7, white has the option of knight into b5 when there is this pin on this diagonal. So what Bharath did was first supported this pawn. Now he's ready to play bishop b7, and if you take on c6, I can just play queen b6, and black is doing fine. So castles, bishop b7, b3, a very common typical pawn sacrifice, b4, knight e4, and knight a4 is also played here, but in the game knight e4 was played, takes, takes, c3, and a3, a5, ab4. And I want you to take some time here and come up with what would you play in this position. Would you take with the pawn back or with the bishop? Now, all those who like really good compact pawn structures would definitely go for the move a into b4, because here you have a protected passer on c3. Why should you take with the bishop when all your pawns are mangled up on the queen side? But Bharath actually played bishop b4, and this shows good understanding as well as good preparation. The point is not that you want a protected passer as such, because even after ab4, bishop f4, you really have to give up something, because these pieces are just very active in this position. So you may have to play knight d7 and give up this pawn, which was seen in Wesley So, Ding Liren versus Wesley So, where after knight c6, queen c8, take, take, d5. And true, you have a protected passer here, but somehow white's play in the center is just much faster. So what Bharat did was, with bishop b4, he gains a crucial tempo to castle. And sometimes in such sharp positions, such dynamic thinking is more important than static thinking of, you know, I want a protected passer. So bishop f4 was played. It's a new move in the position. Castles, queen d3, h6. And here I think Sargissian got a little bit ruffled up here. He didn't understand what is to be done, and he played g4. Looks kind of aggressive, but at the same time black has done nothing wrong, so Bharat just developed his piece. In fact, here after, instead of g4, knight c4 is a better move, because after knight d7 you have bd6, takes, takes, when the position is around equal. G4, knight d7, and now you, if you take on c6, I play queen b6, knight e5 takes, and you will see that this pawn on g4 has just weakened black's white's position. Bg3, take, take, and f5, and black is pushing here. Also, bishop c6 is no longer possible because of knight into e5, and you lose the bishop. So queen g3 was Sargissian's move. And after knight f6, bishop f3, knight d5. So there is no time for white to continue with g5. Also, look carefully that queen d4 was not played by Bharat, because he realized that if his queen is pushed away on the queen side, he could come under really dangerous attack after g5. So that's the reason why he played knight d5, knight d3, takes, takes, bishop d6, again a very powerful move, and after queen e3, queen h4, and now h2 pawn is hanging. Just like that, black is now two pawns up, and bishop d4, he saves his pawn, knight c5. And I like now how Bharat continues rook a7. Bishop a6 was maybe even stronger, but rook a7 is not bad. I was a little bit afraid of some attack like this. Like, for example, if you play d5, cd, knight e6, is this fatal? But there's a very nice line that I found after fe, queen a7, bishop c5. You are attacking the queen, and also there's a mate here. And after queen takes, you take on f3, and after ef3, bishop a6 is mate. King e1, queen g1. So, okay, anyway, in case of d5 also, there are many other ways to continue here. So rook a7, knight d3, rook a8, and here he could have repeated the position, but he played bishop c8, now threatening e5. So knight went back, bd7, and you can see the confidence. You're playing an opponent nearly 300 points above you, 2700 player, very strong player from Armenia, and you say, no, I want to win. And that's how he continues. He plays rook d8. He wants to put his bishop back to e8 and then push the knight away with f6. And here, I think Sargissian lost his cool. He took on c3, but there's no better move as such. So after rook c3, takes, takes, bishop e8, e3, f6, knight takes c6. Maybe it was better to not take the pawn, but already black was better, and after rook a c8, rook into a5, queen c4, king h8 is also another way, but he took on a5, and then after take, take, queen h3, he won a pawn on g4, and now finally after d5, it's your move for black to play and finish off the game. What would you do? Well, well done if you spotted the move rook into c6. That is how the game ended. If you take here with the queen, then I have queen b4 check and win your rook. And if you play d into c6, then both queen d1 and rook d1 are checkmates. So that was a great win for Bharat against Sargissian. He's on 2.5 out of 3. and he is one of the top Indians right now, along with Sethuraman on 2.5 points. And this Aeroflot Open is such a nice hunting ground for these youngsters to score their GM norms. We have Aditya Mittal over here, who is an IM, Shrishwan, who is an IM, several more players, and we are going to follow all of them. For daily reports, check out our news page, www.chessbase.in, where we have analysis of all these games. For now, I hope you enjoyed these two youngsters about whom we spoke, and keep an eye out for them. They are surely going to create more upsets in this event.